Welcome back to The Legend of Master Hunter. Get off me. No. Stay back. Alright, good. I mean, I swear, some days your easy chair just comes alive and gets you. Anyway, we are deep in the sewers, and this place smells terrible. I'm not too eager to go through that crowd of wubbas yet, when I could... There's still stuff we can do productively out here. I guess we'll, work on this. I kind of glossed over it last time, but I'm sure we can get it this time. So we got a lot of decoy potions just sitting around, but we've also got, some troublesome, roach queens to deal with as well. Like this one. This one's gonna be a big problem, actually, because you can see we've got a trapdoor here, so that's just gonna be gone when the red door is also gone. So it looks like I need a decoy to kill this at the very least. And we're gonna need one for this at some point. So when would we be able to do that, actually? I guess we would need one to, like, stick it here or here and then use this one to kill it, maybe? I don't know, that's my best bet. So which one would we drop last? Probably drop, like, this one, or probably this one. We would want someplace that's real close to a decoy potion, so... we're gonna need one, I need one to kill this one, too. Alright, because these will be both be gone. But there's one up here, so we're okay. Alright, and that's a toggle. Hopefully, yeah, Wubba Friend's not gonna block me. Alright, so probably what I want to do first of all is use this decoy, which is very far out of the way. Put that down here. That's gonna track this one over here and this one over here, and that's fine. But no matter what we do, because it's 5 square zone of influences here, I can't even put it, like, here, for example, and creep up on it, because then it's going to move here. But I can wait for it to move twice, so that's fine. Alright, so that kills that one. Then we just need one to deal with this one, and one to deal with this one. Now, I think we should be fine, because, yeah, if we go down here, now we're outside of this roach's 5 square of influence. So you can sneak down here without disturbing it. So what we're going to do is we're going to drop the trapdoors. We'll use this decoy to kill this roach queen, and then use this decoy to kill this roach. And we should be good. Everything else looks like it's just a distraction. So we just need to be able to run to the... we just need to be able to run to that decoy as fast as possible. So not like that, but one more. But the roaches are going to be in the way. So hopefully that's fast enough. Okay, you closed that door up there, so I'm glad I used that decoy already. Alright, I was 2 turns short, so I needed to go as fast as possible, actually. I needed to already be facing west, I think. Or, no, I... So, alright, so how many... So that I wasted, compared to a direct path. Like, let's say I took a direct path. So instead I would be standing here, so I am 3 moves delayed if I do this kind of backswipe thing. So let's compare that to how short I am here. 2. So I can afford to waste 1 move, dealing with the roach, but not any more than that. Alternatively, I could just, use this trick. I don't think it's actually possible to deal with this roach any faster, which is why I'm considering this. But there's a trick where, roach queens, when they spawn, they don't spawn in the square that they just moved from. They will spawn in any other square, when the clock strikes 30, but not the one that they just moved from. And that is often used and, I wouldn't say abused, but certainly exploited. And a lot of the meaner Roach Queen puzzles. So that is a good fact to know, and I don't think I can really do, I don't think there was any way to get there fast enough otherwise. Like, even if I went down, I don't think that's any faster. Alright, so this decoy will keep that roach in place, good. Then I just need to get all these wubbas out of the way, which is only really a matter of time, not anything tricky. And use a decoy to kill this roach. And for this Roach Queen, I don't need a decoy. What I just need to do is hem it in with its own roaches, and then it's easy pickings. Yeah, you better run. Alright, looks like there's no way to the south from here, so let's explore up this way. Alright, more decoys. I'm beginning to sense a theme here. Alright, so what opens this? This. So this opens that. We don't want it to go in here. And in fact, we don't have any choice, though. So maybe use these wubbas to clog this up, maybe? Alright, so if I would want to do that, then I'd probably want to start on this side, maybe. I mean, I could go up, but it seems like I just want to get all this stuff for free and then make trips on the other side. Though, we will need some up here, so maybe it makes sense to actually start this way. Like, sure, I've done this, but then, like, that one gets out, sure. But then we need to be able to distract this wubba away with something else. So, I don't know, we need like 4. I mean, alright, sure, but then what? So I think I want to start with this. That seems reasonable. And this is connected to this, so that's fine. These are actually just for decoration. These are just for decoy not being able to place anything on. So, we might need one decoy here, and maybe, like, another here or something. And then, like, 3 more here. So that's alright, I guess. What we want is for a roach to kind of come over here. So I think we actually want to make, like, a decoy train this way or something. Alright. So let's just start with something we can do immediately, which is this. Except, we can't really get the roach out immediately like that. Well, this is getting more complicated by the minute. Except if we kind of lure it out. Yeah, if we go out this way, then we can lure it out with this other roach. Like, I want this roach behind this wub, of course. Because I need to kill it. But I also need to be able to kill these. But I also want the wubbas out. But I can't really get all of them. I can get, like, this one, maybe. I can probably get this one. I don't think I can get this one. So probably just kill, like, yeah, do this, let this roach out. Alright, that makes sense. Except this roach is trapped, so, alright, so I'll use one decoy to escape, so I'll use this one. Sure. So now I'm back out in the main area, alright. We'll get somewhere soon, believe me, we'll get there. In fact, might as well just stash you where I want you, which is going to be down here. That way we won't have to think about you later. Except I can't go up this high. Another problem. But that's well, it's not okay. I can't go step up this high. Unless I take a decoy here. But these are, yeah, I already trapped these, actually. Alright. Alright, glad I noticed that ahead of time. So, we want to put this off until later. But yeah, I'm thinking this is the idea. I think we just want to put 4 wubbas here or something. Maybe just 3. I think 3 would be enough. Because then the red door would be dropped. I would go the long way down here. Except now, yeah, things would get lured in here. So I need, like, well, if I got the movement order perfect, I would need 4, but to make it not movement order dependent, I would need 5, which means I would need all these wubbas, which is kind of disconcerting. I only have 6 decoys. That's not good. And I need, like, 1 here and 1 here, so that would mean I have a maximum of 4 to play with, and I need, I would need, like, 1 here or something. So what's the maximum number I could use? I could use 1 here to get this one. Then I could lure it out the west, that's fine. And I would need, like, 1 here to put it here, and then, like, 2 more or something? No, but that's not even enough, is it? like if I have one here, then like it's gonna be like say facing, you know, north or something. Then one's here. I need a way to get it here, so I can lure everything out. And I also want to put like one here. So if it's fit, you know, if one's here and it kills this, that's not good enough. That you know, that'll get this out, but that doesn't let this one out. So I would need, like, all four here, wouldn't I? Like, one, two, and then, like, three, and then... But, no, then that would block this up. Ugh, jeez. Yeah, so, like, if one's here, then I'm, like, thinking, like, oh, well, what if we have one... We draw the Wubba up here like before, then we put one decoy here, and then we kill this one somehow, but then there's no way to make a, you know, run our decoy train far enough away so that this one is closer than whatever this one is, because we just end up with like one here, for example. Although if it were a tie, then that would be fine, because I could get this one to be tied with the other one here on this square. Let me show you, like this and this would be the same distance away from this. But that still leaves us one short for getting this one out. So either four is enough here, if we go south, which it could be. I'm only actually going to be here for two turns, so if we arrange the movement order correctly, hopefully that won't be a problem, and this one will still be here. Or hold on, no. This is going to be clogged up. So in theory, actually, we only really need, like, a few. We need, like, enough so that one goes, like, here or here. And then, like, this one gets clogged up. But as soon as we make it out of this hallway, and this is blocked, which I guess we only need four for, yeah, just four, then the roach stays here, it goes south, and then we're good. Then it doesn't matter what happens on this column. So we might not actually need all five of these. We might only need four. So in that case, I guess we'd probably, like, put one here, one here, one here, and one here or something. And then hope movement order is good enough for that, and this one stays in place. In fact, well, no, we can't go down here. We have to go down here, which involves this long column. Alright, so that's probably good enough, then. So, yeah, probably start like we did before. That's probably fine. And maybe just put this one here for the time being. And now I'll have to find a place to use two in a row. So this is probably the most opportune time to do that. We can kill this. We just can't get all three of the Wubbas out. That's all. So yeah, let's just let all of these roaches out. The roaches themselves are a distraction. Don't care about them. Alright, so I'll leave this one here so it'll be in a fine place for later when we go down here. And then we just want the ones that can get out with a minimum of effort, so that's that one. We do still need one up here, because we do need to do at least that. Then kill this, I guess. And then let one out. Sure. So we're not going to be able to get any more over there, though. So maybe I... Alright, so I place three here. But that means I would have to place one of these anyway. So this would... Yeah. So that's not... So unless I use one like this... Yeah, I should use one like that. Should... yeah, there's no rush to use one to here, one there. So that's fine. I can use one there later. And that doesn't matter whether I use a decoy here or here. That's just the same thing. So, you know, for all intents and purposes, might as well use this one, I guess. Let's bring this one out first. Okay. Alright, so you come across, there's no longer any point in having this trapdoor, so I'll just drop it now. Then, one kills the roach. I can... I want you to go in there, sure. the only way to draw Wubbas in is through here, like this. Okay, this is another way. This actually works a lot better. Okay, so that way I don't actually need to use this upper passageway at all. I can draw an arbitrary number of Wubbas through here like this. I mean, it'll take a while, mind you, but, you know, it'll still work. So I can get one more like that and one more like that, so that's all good. That's all well and good. I could break things by just, you know, using a decoy to hit this orb. But that's so obviously broken, I'm not gonna do that, unless I really have to. I mean, that would just be rude, breaking a puzzle like that. I mean, I'm not a savage. And, yeah, you get out. So, hopefully four Wubbas is enough. Let's just hope. In fact, you stay up there, sure. So there's another... Okay, well, that's fine. No, actually, it's not. I can't lure them back up. Okay. I can't lure them back up. So then what? Okay, so then... Yeah, there's no way to avoid them going all the way down. So, what? Do you seriously need all five? I guess you seriously need all five. Because of the way this works, and you have to lure them all, because you can't lure them all in at once, you have to do them one at a time. Which means that every time you do this, this one gets cinched back down. So yeah, it's starting to look like we actually need all five in there. Except that we don't actually need... It's okay if it's on the arrow, as long as we can actually reach it to kill it. Which is probably on purpose. Okay. So, yeah, that's probably intentional that you can't get all the Wubbas out then. I guess that's probably on purpose. I don't know. Maybe the architect can comment more about it if he ever shows up, ever. But, yeah, this is interesting, at least. I mean... It's kind of tedious to watch, I'm afraid, but, I mean, resource optimization is certainly a valid room category, for sure. And it's kind of tricky seeing the subtleties of decoys that you have to consider here. This is a neat mechanism, too. Wubbas are your friends, usually. Alright, finally, some bombs. I like bombs. Alright, so... We're gonna drop all these. We want to wake all these up. We don't want them to go in here, though. We also don't want them to go in there. But we need to wake this one up, and we also need to wake this one up. So we need, probably like... Well, but see, we can't let them get in there either. But yeah, we want to wake that up. So, let's see. So how many decoys do we have? We have these three... Do we have any others? It doesn't seem like it. There's just a bunch of Wubbas. I can't really use the Wubbas in here. They're just a distraction for this. We can get some Tar Babies, but I don't see what good that does us. I mean, sure, they're Tar Babies, but they don't do anything here, I don't think. Alright, let's just kind of try and do some stuff and see what happens. So... We could wake this up, or we could just stab it. Stabbing it is equal, so maybe doing this is slightly better. We also don't want the Wubbas to actually interfere with us while we're in the trapdoor parts, so, let's blow them up. Yeah, that blew up most of them, at least. What I did there is I just wanted more space, though. Alright, so that gets rid of those, so none of them will bother us on our way out. So, let's see, where do we hide? We hide up there, so we want to drop all of these, but leave this open. So, probably leave, like, a diagonal passage or something. Probably drop all these. Alright, so, as before, we'll do this. And then probably do something like that. And then, just use these all ahead of time. Now, we can manually wake up these. These are not the problem. This is not the problem. This is the problem. And so's this, for that matter. Let's see. So we could put one here and one here, maybe, and that would work, I think. In fact, we could just stab them because that's an equal number again. Like, it's if there were three, then this wouldn't work. But because there's only two, we just use one to stab this and one to stab this. I was thinking about putting one, like, just here, not stabbing this, but then you might as well just stab it. And then one here, but then to wake this up, but then again, you might as well just stab it. So unless there were, like, two here, like, one, two, three or something, then you'd have to do something like that. But, you know, decoys have swords, you might as well use them. Gotta put them to work. Alright, so now all we need to do is sneak in here without, again, the wubba's bothering us. Because, I can't really deal with them. So, I think we just need to lure them all down here, say. Sure. And stick them in here. And wubba prison, alright. Now, as long as we can as long as we stay here, the eyes won't be, attracted to the decoys. They'll be attracted to B-through. So all the remaining ones should just go straight to us. Good. Alright. So again, some subtleties going on here. Some traps. But, this is how you can use floor to make good traps. You know, you gotta execute all of your geometrical options, you know. So the funny thing about sewers... Wubba. I don't know if that's Mr. or Monsieur or what. I think it's just a typo. But anyway, the funny thing about sewers is, as you know, there are many locations in the underground that get infested. You know, your storehouses, your dungeons, your prisons, your secret laboratories that have illicit experiments in them. But the sewers are the one thing you can't really prohibit. I mean, sure, you can say that, you built this dungeon wrong. You built it in too moldy of a spot. That's why you're getting infested. And, sure, that's, you can take certain steps to prevent that. But a sewer, inherent to its very design, it's got organic material coming through it. You've got, please no, absurd, just absurd jokes, but, you're gonna have food, you're gonna have, lots of liquid stench, you're gonna have all the kinds of stuff that roaches love, and there's not a heck of a lot you can do about it, just because of that's the way it works. We do not want to get bogged down here. So, I mean, you can take certain precautionary measures, but you're just, ultimately, you're gonna have rivers of stuff flowing through here. So, this is just one of the places that's gonna get infested pretty much no matter what you do. Right away. Alright, don't trap me in here, Mr. Wubba. I don't have time to put up with that kind of nonsense. Okay, you just want to keep me from killing the queen. Fair enough. You've got friends, I can understand that, but, we've got to kill those friends, so, we got to make way for progress. Anyway, where was I? Yes, sewers. Alright, we want to blow this thing up. This tar blob is giving us some problems. We're gonna be attacked from behind no matter what, it seems like. And we don't want to get bogged down there. Because you saw what happens. If we kill one monster per every two turns, that's not good enough. We want to be able to at least kill a few more. So yeah, we can't really be fast enough, I don't think. Yeah, not fast enough. There'll be some other way to get in there, I'm sure. So maybe if we sneak away through the top, then that'll work. Yeah. Blow up some of those wubbas too, sure. That should give us a little bit of a tactical edge. And now that we can get at that queen down there, we should be good. I'll save that bomb. I don't know what I need it for. I might need that for later. Alright, you get back there. I'll need to redefine my approach so the Roach Queen doesn't quite run away like that. Yeah, I want to lure the next wave down there. Sometimes you just want to wait a wave so that the next wave will take a better direction towards you. Alright. So I think we're mostly stable now. I think all we need to do is kill this Tar Mother that's going to give us some problems. And then maybe blow up the rest of the Wubbos because we don't want them chasing us after the brain. So that's probably what this other bomb is for. Alright, so... It can toggle those, it can open those, and it can open that. So probably, I guess you just need to kill the Tar Mother. I guess that's probably what's gonna cause it to open the next door. I mean, you know, so you do have to guess the scripting sometimes, but I think this is still probably reasonable. You can make some reasonable educated guesses. Just, you know, kill things as they become accessible. That's your job as a Smite Master. But yeah, I think that I don't see any way to get into that area. If he's just gonna toggle that again, I'm assuming that's probably just not a place we can go. Now, let's dodge around this way. That's a little bit better. And we don't need to clear all the tar, just enough of it so that we can get back out, like this. Alright. Alright, so maybe if we kill all the brains, that'll cause it to do something. Yeah, I guess that's an option. We could also use that bomb to kill some stuff. Okay, maybe we can sneak in here to kill the roaches then. Sir? Okay, there we go. I don't know why it waited, but I was expecting those to be a problem earlier in the room, to be honest with you. And what about the Wraithwings? You got any... Gonna kill those anytime soon? Alright, I kinda just went down there. Alright. Not really sure why it did some of those things, but, maybe I can take a look at the scripting later and figure that out. Alright, but, you know, for a Neither-style room, that was pretty neat. A lot of sub-goals going on here. Some subtle tactics going on, too, with being surrounded. Hopefully that was some good fighting going on there. Alright, looks like that takes care of this section. Still a lot of sewers left, though. Let's use our sword to help us elbow our way through these guys. Okay, what's up with this room? Alright. So, last time we couldn't really do anything, because I think this roach got trapped immediately. Because we were down here, and this roach went in here, and that's obviously suboptimal compared to, well, I don't know, Alright, what's going on here? So, I think we need to use a decoy to keep this roach in particular occupied, so we might as well at least keep this roach occupied, too. Oh, you again. Alright. I'll find you later, don't worry. Alright, so probably we just want to blow that up, probably. How many more? We're going to get a lot of wubbas on our tail pretty soon, though. So I think we want to lure some down there and kind of out of our way, so that these ones will be the only ones we have to worry about. So probably something like this. And then, yeah, all of them are trapped on the west wall. Now it's just, just those three. We can deal with three. Alright, so that takes care of that. That takes care of that roach. We still have two decoys here. That's plenty. We could use one to kill that. And I guess we were expected to use one of them to help us out up there, maybe? But, thanks to my expert wubba handling skills, I only needed one of these, not two. Alright, so we'll leave a decoy potion unused. Alright. Okay, so that seems to be all of this kind of entryway foyer. I kind of want to see what other rooms are available, because nobody wants to wade through a giant rectangular block of wubbas. That's just boring. Alright, so let's see what's over here, then. Alright, more vertical hallway, as I suspected. There's our blue door. Working on that already. It's usually a safe bet to say there's a blue door everywhere you go. Sometimes there isn't, but most of the time there is. More goblins. Fortunately, we have some more of our wubba friends to help us out. So, this is gonna be a little bit annoying. Just because the wubbas are kind of gonna cut off some of our convenient angles of advancement. But kind of, it helps us block the goblins in too, so alright. So we managed to kill those just by kind of trapping them against this wall. But I was also thinking we might have been able to blow them up, so let's at least blow up the wubbas, because you know, we haven't met our explosion quota for today. Yeah, there we go. And nothing doing here, at least from this angle. Too true, Beethro, too true. But then you know that the architect would just give you a mop. Hmm? So neither of you two are a sell-off. Alright, so clearly, well, that pretty much spoke for itself, but alright, so then we've got a timer here. So probably what we want to do is pre-drop as many of these trapdoors as we can. Then we'll want a path from, like, here or so. That's kind of a... Oh yeah, because it's blowing up this bomb. That's why this one is being added on, because it's from this. So we'll probably want to pre-drop as much of this stuff as we can, then do this, then do that, and run out. Because the only things that we can't really drop are these fuses. I mean, we can, you know, make them shorter to some extent, but not a huge extent. But this is a sufficiently long timer, and this blows up this, and due to the way that bombs and fuses work, this bomb is not going to light this fuse, even though it's connected, because this one's on a wall. So I think all we need to do is drop as many of these as we can, then light this, drop this, hurry over here, light this, drop that, and get out. We can't really drop this beforehand, but that's okay. In fact, by the time this is all blown up, there's going to be, like, barely anything left, and this is pretty long anyway, so that should be good. So we just need to do as much, much pre-work as we can. And it's fine if we leave that there, we'll get that last. Except we don't want to drop those yet. So, yeah, we'll leave this open and get all this. And, yeah, probably just like that, I guess. Except we still need to, you know, leave a path. You know, that's pretty important. Alright, that should be good enough. The thing is, we're gonna be bottlenecked by the wait for this to blow up anyway, so I don't have to do a perfect job here, just a good enough job. Because probably what's going to happen is I'm going to be, like, you know, so incredibly efficient and handsome that I'm just going to be waiting for this to blow up anyway. Let's see here. So, actually, this is a little bit more complicated than it looks, because I'm going to have to, I can't cross over this twice. And if I go here diagonally to light this, I could hide in here and then do that, go in here and then that. So what would that look like? I'd drop some of these, but leave like a two wide thing up here. Drop the rest of these, leave this two wide strip. Then I go over here, leave this, and then later on I come back here, go here, cut this, light this, go up here. And then go in here and drop these and then come back. That's probably still enough time because, like I said, this is a really long timer. Also, this never actually starts, does it? Does it? Okay, there's a secret wall here. Okay. And there's also a secret wall here and a secret wall here. So blowing up these bombs does actually start the fuse because they're secret walls. Now, you know, you should make these crumbly so you can actually see them. But the point still stands. These actually do light the fuses. Okay. Let's just try that out and see what that looks like on camera. And if I don't like it, I'll try again. Alright, and similarly with this. This is not as much of a concern, so just do this. And then we just need to leave in a very short, efficient path like that, except that's really the best we can do. Alright, we'll only need, maybe not quite that much. Alright. We will be going in here and out here, so probably something like, this then, and then cross over like this. Yeah, so that's, alright. So I've lit this. This gives me enough time to escape over here. Now I drop the rest of that. Oh, we woke up the conspirator. Except I didn't leave myself enough room here, because I, like, dropped that and lit that. Alright, that's a bit awkward. See, like, that's the thing. I want to sneak past this and drop most of these, because this takes a while, you know. I don't want to drop this yet. So I guess ideally what I would like to do is just drop this and then come in here from another angle. But that's still a little bit awkward. But it's fine if I pre-trim this, actually. Yeah. Because like I said, I was planning on lighting it from this square anyway. So that means it's safe if I cut the fuse ahead of time. So I'm going to do this and keep dropping the trapdoors. Okay, so that, so sure. So I go up here and I do that, and then I just drop these, and that's fine. And you'll do the same thing as before. So then, yeah, again, probably something like this. Kaboom. And then we drop these and we race the bombs. We have to wait here for this to blow up, but that's okay. And that gets blown up, and then we're here, and we have beaten this timer by quite a lot. And this room is not going to save a demo, because there's no monsters in here, so I will save a demo. So there's no monster in here, and there's no conquer token, because this was before conquer tokens were invented, because this is a Journey to Rooted Hold era hold. And, let's see, so this is a, yeah, again, this is a trapdoor gate, and there's no shortcut or anything, so hopefully I don't have to do this again. If I do, we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. So, what's in here? Ah, jeez. Alright. Well, here's another required room, and if we can just make it to the end, our job will be a lot easier. In fact, we have to hit this because of this. I think, yeah, there's no red door, obviously, because we can't even drop all these. So I think all we have to do is just throw ourselves at it. You know, have faith in ourselves that we can actually get through this. So, yeah, we want to start something like that, sure. And we also have to keep in mind that not everything in the room is... a trapdoor, or not trapdoor, a yellow door. So it's still kind of in our interest to kill as much of these as possible, just to make sure that none of them get trapped on regular wall at the end. But at the same time, once these are dropped, these are just regular floor, so our options for mobility will get a lot easier. And this will be how we get out, sure. So I think we just need to watch out for trouble cases like this one, and then we should be good to go. Oops. So sure, that's a nice thing about Seep, is they'll generally, like, reach you within a few turns, but then once everybody's gotten into position, you can usually just, you know, stand here and just swing your sword back and forth, and you're in a stable position, and no other Seep are going to be able to get to you. So I kind of want to leave some of these undropped, but at the same time, I think I've got this whole southwest corner mostly figured out. I just have to be able to get over here. Which is going to be kind of annoying, actually. Yeah, how am I going to deal with these West Seep? That's a good question. I mean, I can't drop this, because that's, wait, hold on, what did the start of the room look like? Did I make that part, did I ruin that part by accident? No, I didn't. That's what it started as. That's what it started as. So how do you kill these seamen? Because one of them is going to be, like, even in the best case, where I somehow managed to use movement order to kill one of them over here, there's still going to be two left. So I need some way to get in and adjacent to them and then back out. Oh, what am I talking about? This is dropped. This will be floor. So I can just go here, walk through here, and get out. That's fine. Unfortunately, I didn't step on a checkpoint, so I have to redo the start of the room. But now that I know that's not going to be a problem, I think I could just proceed with confidence. Alright, and this was the general route I took. Let's get rid of that highlighting. Now, my only concern is that I might be making an undroppable wall of trapdoors, but I think the doors are well enough connected that that shouldn't be an issue. So let's just do some diagonal stepping like that when we can, and hopefully we won't run into problems. I think this room is just meant to be intimidating rather than, you know, actually a roadblock. So hopefully its bark is worse than its bite, and we can keep going. Otherwise, I guess we'll see what our problem is, when we run into it. Alright, so kabam! That gets rid of a bunch of seep, and now we just need to gingerly make our way, kind of like over here, for example. We might as well kill this while we have our chance, though. Alright, so it's all just regular floor, Take advantage of it where you can. It's nice and safe. Alright, and we can walk through that. Okay. That looked pretty scary, but was not actually that bad. And where'd you go? Oh, you ran off. That's right. Alright, anything suspicious in here? Yeah. Man, they nailed this thing to the ground. Who would even do that? Jeez. And you again. Alright, so I think this is our shortcut back. I'll probably just kill these and then get back to the main area and then end the episode. So here's our problem. How are we gonna kill the snake? Like that, apparently. Okay. Yeah, alright. That kind of happened by accident. I was planning about how to make it happen down here with this convenient one square wide thing, but this kind of happened, so I mean, this is narrow enough. It's pretty narrow. So, yeah. I mean, I guess another thing you can do is you can shape the rattlesnake so that there's a, so that there's like a one tile wide niche in its own body, and then you just stop it somewhere in the room, and then the body stops, and it's just a wall. That's a good trick to know, but, you know, I'm not going to demonstrate that. You kind of get the idea with how I describe that, I hope. Alright. So we opened that door. And down here is the blue door. And over there is another blue door, which I guess is kind of a shortcut. And then if we go up here, we can get back here, and that puts us on the other side of this puzzle. So you don't never have to do it again. Alright, this is probably a fine place to stop. We got plenty of places to, well, we actually only really have one, actually, don't we? Yeah, there's nothing left up here. And I went up here and did all this, and this is just a side area. So, alright, so we might as well at least walk down here. So, maybe we can just skip the wubbas. Alright, there we go. And we got a blue door which can go in here. Alright, nuts to you, wubbas. Who cares about you? Alright, so next time, way too many evil eyes.